Welcome back to another video. I'm Daniel Abendroth. This is Reaper for Podcasting. And yes, I am rocking a gold sequin backdrop behind me. The reason for that is because almost all of my sound panels fell off the wall. And I'm a little discouraged about that. I don't know how to get them to stay up permanently. I guess not. I need something semi-permanently. So if you have any suggestions on how to adhere my sound panels to the wall without damaging the wall, I would love to hear them. Leave a comment, send me a message, please help me out. Until then, we're going to rock the gold sequins. So in this episode, we're going to talk about RX Connect. And if you're not familiar, RX Connect is a plugin that allows your DAW to communicate with RX so that way you can process your audio within your DAW through the RX system or whatever. It's something you can do in Audition and I think Pro Tools. It doesn't work the same way in Reaper, so I'm not sure exactly how it works, but I'm going to show you the way to do it using Reaper. So let's go ahead and just dive on in. So this is a fresh install of Reaper, and Reaper has the ability to connect to an external editor. So that's what we're going to use in order to essentially replicate the RX Connect functionality inside Reaper. So the first thing you need to do is, one, make sure you have RX installed. And secondly, go into your preferences. On Windows, it's Control P. On Mac, it's Command P, I believe. Scroll all the way down to the very bottom, and you want to click on External Editors. And then click on Add. And then under Primary Editor, click Browse. And then you're going to navigate to your RX installation, which for me is right here. So double-click that. Click OK. And now we have RX set up as an external editor within Reaper. So let's go ahead and take a look at how that works. So we're going to open up a project. So this is an episode of the Podcast Editor's Mastermind that I edited. If you're a professional podcast editor, then I encourage you to take a listen. There's a lot of great value in there. So let's just go ahead and let's say right here. Let's say there's a section here that needs a little something, maybe a little EQ or maybe a D-clip. I don't know. Just something that you want to clean up in RX. All you have to do is right-click, open items in Editor, open items in Izotope RX6 Audio Editor. And that brings up that file. So this is the entire file. So now you can go in, add whatever other processes you need in order to clean it up even more. Now, let's say you don't actually want to bring in that entire file. You just want a small section. Let's say right here needs something. So Shift S to split it on the highlighted part. And now we can go ahead and right click, open items in editor, and then open item copies in Izotope RX6 or whatever version of RX you have. Now what this does is it makes a copy of that item. And now you just have that one small section that you can add more processing to. And then when you go back into Reaper, you'll see there are two takes. So you can just click on which one you want to use. So right now it's two takes of the same exact audio. So I'm just going to do something crazy just to show you what it's like. And I'm going to boost the gain by way too much. So that way it's very clear. So once you did the processing you want, go ahead and overwrite original file. And then back in Reaper, you can see we have the original, and then you have that crazy-looking process one. So let's take a listen. So here's the original take.
That point, that came last in my kind of development.
And now the over-processed one.
Business at that point, that came last in my kind of.
I'm so sorry that you had to hear that. But you can see how you can actually update the files in RX. So just to recap, right-click. Open items in editor, and this first one right here is going to open the entire audio file. So if you need to add something to the entire file, use that one. But if you just want to add processing to a single item, that's what you do. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you found that helpful. If you did, be sure to leave a like, subscribe, comment. You know how it works on YouTube. Do all the things. And if you have a question that you want answered live, I am going to be starting up a live Q&A thing in the Facebook group. So if you haven't already joined that Facebook group, it's reaperforpodcasting.com/group. It'll take you directly there. Join. And then if you have any questions, send me a message and we will hop on a live stream and I'll help you through whatever problem you're having, as well as get advice and tips from the community over on Facebook. So be sure to send me a message, and until next time, I'll see you later.